Let's head now to the United States, where politicians are still bickering over how to solve the nation's debt crisis. Our US correspondent Daniel Sutton joins us now with the details from the US. Dan, this is quite extraordinary and getting very serious.
Well, Tash, it's now less than a week before the United States risks defaulting on its bills, and politicians here, it seems, are still no closer to nutting out a deal which will allow the US to borrow more money. The public is furious. On Capitol Hill, the phones in politicians' offices are running so hot the system went into meltdown this morning. Several politicians' websites crashed. Why? Well, perhaps because of some comments the president made in a televised speech last night where he warned of a deep economic crisis if the issue isn't resolved.
The American people may have voted for divided government, but they didn't vote for a dysfunctional government. So I'm asking you all to make your voice heard. If you want a balanced approach to reducing the deficit, let your member of Congress know.
Now, the plan the president has endorsed includes spending cuts and tax hikes. The Republicans, they want a different plan. They don't want tax hikes at all. And they've put forward a plan that only allows the US to borrow more money for about 6 months, although it appears there's a $150 billion hole in that plan, which has just been identified. And today, the boss of the International Monetary Fund weighed in as well.
A very, very, very serious event, not for the United States alone, but for the global economy at large, because the consequences would be far-reaching.
Now, it seems some investors agree that the US dollar is no longer a safe bet. At last check, the currency was hovering somewhere between $1.09 and $1.10 Australian. Tash?
Very serious story. Now, Dan, there's another political sex scandal brewing over there.
Well, Tash, everyone will remember Anthony Weiner, the Democratic congressman who resigned after sending lewd pictures of himself to people via social networks and over mobile phones. Well, now another politician has bitten the dust as well. He's also a Democratic congressman, and his name is David Wu from Oregon. He has been accused of making unwanted aggressive sexual advances to a fundraiser's teenage daughter. Now, there is another scandal brewing as well, and this time it's at the September 11 site in New York, and it's about a giant metal cross which has been built. It's standing on the site there. It's made from two metal beams which withstood the attack on September 11. Now, just weeks out from the 10-year anniversary, a group of atheists has filed a lawsuit demanding it be taken down. They say it shouldn't be there because God didn't stop the 3,000 people being killed. A big can of worms there indeed, Tash.
Absolutely. Won't get started this morning. Now, Dan, a little girl's been bitten by a shark. How's she doing?
This little six-year-old girl by the name of Lucy is very lucky indeed. Would you believe she was standing in just 45 centimetres of water, paddling around off the coast of North Carolina? Her mother was right next to her. This two-metre shark swam up and latched onto her legs. She was bleeding profusely. She apparently asked her parents to say a prayer for her as they dragged her to shore. Now, she's okay, and at a media conference today, would you believe this, she said she'd forgiven the shark.
Why'd you forgive that nice shark?
Her. Now, Dan, the woman in your next story isn't very forgiving, and she's a lot older.
No, she's 70, and boy, you don't want to run into her in a dark alley. Meet Bonnie. She's a grandmother who is pretty handy with a baseball bat. When an intruder broke into her home and took off all his clothes, she was worried he was going to come after her or perhaps her grandson, who was asleep upstairs. So she pulled out a baseball bat, and boy, she went after him.
I said, oh, no, you didn't. And then that's when I grabbed the bat. And it still didn't impress him that I was going to use it. He figured I was just showing it. So I hit him with it and beat him out the door.
Now, the man grabbed his clothes and did a runner. At last check, police were still looking for him, but good on you, Bonnie. Now, Tash, a few weeks ago we told you about an amazing story where a couple had found what they believed was an imprint of Jesus on their receipt that they got from the local store. Well, it's happened again, sort of, and this time it's in ivy, if you like. Check out this picture of a tree in Ohio. This is an ivy tree that locals in South Toledo think looks a lot like Jesus with his arm outstretched across the roadway. Make up your own mind. But the weird thing is, it's right across the road from a Catholic church. Tash?
Oh, my goodness. Thanks for the update and all the stories this morning. Our US correspondent Dan Sutton joining us there live from LA.